Yeah, nothing else to do. Shit on his dick. It's fucking keeping me going.
Hey man, what's going on, bro? Why you sitting there? Why you sitting in this little spot here? What happened to you, man?
2022, dope. What the fuck are you doing here? I thought that you passed on to another afterlife.
Well, though, you really fucking let yourself go. Why are you sitting there like you having fucking scoliosis or some fucking shit? Get your ass up, bro. Like, we got a video to make.
What is dead shit that you don't understand, bro? Like, no one's gonna watch this. It's over. It's done. It's finished. We have been downfall. We have barely fallen off, bro. We've fallen off. So stop crying. Stop complaining, because this ain't gonna work anymore.
Bro, if you don't get your sorry ass up and fucking get this shit rolling and revive this channel, I am going to come to your house and I'm going to absolutely beat the shit out of you, fucking
boy. Alright, you got me sold, yeah, so what's next?
I'm back from Phoenix, we're back at the Prime Capital House in...
Oh no, man, fuck this channel, I fucking hate this channel ever, it's my dad's dang life. Why do we gotta do this one, man? Why do we have to do these four dumbasses? I don't wanna fucking react to them, I'd rather go back to the streets of New York and just sit down and cry when I drink a beer. Just sit down in the rain, drinking a cold Corona in the streets when it's raining, man. I don't
want to
watch this.
I'm sorry, but you just have to, bro. You just have to watch these guys, you know? Come on, bro. Bring it back. Bring us back, bro. Come on, Dad. We'll revive your channel no matter what.
Oh, really? That's what my wife said after she left me. First of all, who is this fucking dumbass with this little squeaky? You look like me, bro. You look like me. Look at me. Come on, bro. Come on, stop fucking capping me, you fucking copycat. Go take a hike somewhere else. This man gets struck by lightning out in the rain.
Really setting the vibe for this video because Yana was just scrolling on TikTok and she came across this video. Oh, yo, you hear that?
Yeah, man, that's the sound of God being disappointed in you.
Yo,
the weather
is super
crazy.
Loud.
Coming
I know,
from
I know.
Arizona to here.
Arizona?
Oh, really? It's not like the like fucking America's connected to Canada. Come on, bro. Look at the map one more time and see how's that bus.
Toronto compared to Toronto is night and day.
It is literally torrential downpour.
But yeah, she came across this video of, what did it say? There was like this house where people have been going missing?
Yeah, so...
I wonder what happens there. It's not like there's a fucking serial killer out there on the loose trying to kill people, eh? Why do I have to react to him again? Please, just let me go back to the streets.
Bro, if you like stop crying, maybe we'll get through this video. If you stop complaining.
Oh really? Is that what you do? Oh, I don't know. No. I don't want to hear it. I hear you complaining most of the time in the video. I don't want to hear you.
There's a house, and apparently families that go there just go missing.
Like your parents. They left you because they were fucking disappointed of what they created in this world.
According to this TikTok.
So let me take a wild guess. You rented the house.
No fucking shit. No shit, Sherlock. Of course he fucking rented the house. Like, why are you in his front porch in his house? While he's standing right in front of you. Walking on a dream. This looks like this is Toronto. Why does it look like LA combined with other cities in the US?
Are you the homeowner?
Like, do you own this place? We're here for the Airbnb.
Yeah, we booked it for.
Yeah, we literally just booked like 2 hours ago. We were just looking for the homeowner. We're trying to check in. Over there. Okay.
Thanks.
Alright, thank you.
What's that guy on about, dude? What a weirdo.
So you guys, I know Stromedy was a fucking asshole. Listen, he could be death. He could be death, alright? He could be built. What? He probably has something going on with his life. Maybe you should be fucking stepping a dick.
Yo, this place is so eerie.
I'm sorry, this area is eerie. This shit's fucking like a paradise for some people, bro. Like, come on, it's beautiful as fuck, bro. If you have terrible taste of what a nice house would look like.
Oh, is that him? Is that the one? Hey!
Hello. Hi.
Hey, how's it going?
We have a booking for today.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're the tenants. Yeah, sorry about the last minute booking there. Oh yeah. Sorry.
It's okay.
Oh my God, it's fucking Marty McFly from Back in the Future. What are you doing here?
How are you? My name's Kyle. Nice
to meet you. Hi.
Hey man, I don't know if you know this, but when is Back in the Future Part 4 coming out? Come on. Come on, you can tell me. Yeah, well, I won't tell anybody. I'm sorry to tell you guys this. This is Back in the Future Part 4. Canadian edition.
I'm alright.
Yeah, sure, man.
Come on in, guys. Come on in.
Yeah, we just thought it'd be nice to get away from the city. You know, just a little weekend getaway.
Yeah.
Oh, this place has been in the family for almost 100 years. But don't believe those scary articles. It's fake news. It's fake news.
Bro, this fucking dude just sound like Gilbert Godfrey. Sweet Jesus, rest in peace.
Oh, fake news, yeah.
Why do you have this camera?
Oh, no, we're just doing like a little, like...
vacation vlog, kind of.
These fucking people, YouTubers. I knew it. This guy looks like a fucking dickhead. He sounds like a moron. He sounds like an idiot himself. I'm gonna kill him with him. I'm gonna be the enemy cleaver. His flesh.
Let's see. First, there's an introductory greeting.
Sign in. All right.
That I'm supposed to read. It's kind of a legal thing, you know.
Yeah. Yeah.
Welcome to Freddy Fazbear's Pizza.
What the fuck is a Freddy Fazbear's Pizza?
What's going on here? Where fantasy and fun come to life.
There's no fantasy if fuck comes alive and strawberries, man, I'm telling you.
Upon discovering that damage or death has occurred, a missing person report will be filed within 90 days or as soon as property and premises have been thoroughly cleaned and bleached and the carpets have been replaced. Blah, blah, blah. Now, that might sound bad, I know.
It does sound bad. Is he killing people? What is he doing?
The animatronic characters here do get a bit quirky at night, but do I blame
them?
Damn,
bro.
No.
Yeah, they do look like electronics.
Those same stupid songs for 20 years, and I never got a bath, I'd probably be a bit irritable at night, too.
See you guys later! Have fun!
Oh, damn, you gotta get the doc back, boys.
Then he waddled away, waddle, waddle, till the very next day, bum, bum, bum.
How are you?
We're looking for the lake.
Yeah, we're just going down by the dock.
I don't think he talks much, dude.
Yeah, alright, see ya, have a good one.
Lost it. I told you. I'm the weird one.
There could be an explanation as to why he doesn't talk much. He's seen a lot of things, or he was just instructed to never speak to anyone.
Oh, I understand. He went to Vietnam and fought and got PTSD. It's fine. You know? A lot of people's great grandfather, mostly the grandfathers, get PTSD and never speak again.
You can just leave it right there. It's fine.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Later. Oh, and by the way, he said not to-
Why is this man delivering packages at midnight, bro? Like, come on, bro. You that desperate? You get paid minimum wages? Come on, bro. Where's the respect for yourself? So, what do you think about the blast of the past? You think you got it? You think it's worth for another video? Oh no, dog. I'd rather go back to. No, man, we ain't getting views out. This ain't reviving shit. I'm telling you, bro. I'm telling you. I'd rather fucking live in the streets, you know what I mean? You know, this ain't paying the bills. This ain't paying my Netflix subscription.
Hey, I'm Sarah, and for the last few years, I've been going to this super expensive private school for rich kids.
What is this fucking LA where celebrities put their kids in the most expensive fucking place in the imaginary United States? Come on now. We all know the reality.
Everyone wore designer clothes and looked at me like I was a misfit.
Oh, I'm sorry, you said this looks this looks rich? This looks like what people actually wear every day as adults. They wear that out in the street, and yeah, that's not rich. That's just normal people. Just wandering on Earth right now.
Maybe because I wore H&M and didn't have the latest iPhone.
Listen, this is shocking. I don't have an iPhone. Listen, you guys could be Steve Jobs slaves while I'll be over here chilling with an Android phone and knocking my data slowed down, my phone getting slowed down every time there's a fucking new iPhone coming out.
The cool kids completely ignored me, so I asked my mom's billionaire husband if he would give me some money for shopping.
Well, this guy's shocked. He's shocked for his life. He said, Gold Digger wants my money? What? I'm just joking. I'm pulling your strings here.
He kindly gave me $200, but I told him, I'm sorry, but that's just not enough.
That's not enough? What are you fucking buying, Gucci? Oh, this fucking joke's that, man. Oh my god, the jokes come out of my mouth. It's hilarious. I'm not gonna lie, bro.
Classmates all wear designer clothes. I think I'll need at least $3,000 to buy good enough clothes to fit in.
$3,000? What, are you gonna buy multiple outfits? What does an average person need $3,000 for? You want, what are you trying to buy? You're trying to buy a fucking car for $3,000? It's enough to pay rent in California. What is going on here?
He shook his head in disappointment, but gave me the money anyway. Then I went on
a lot of questions in this one frame. Like, why does she have slaves carrying her shit? And why does this guy do not have a mouth? Like, come on, you can't even draw a mouth? A simple fucking line? Come on, no, that's lazy, bro. They'd be like, oh, we just gave, we're done. We gave up. We gave up on this guy's mouth. We can't do that, so hard making mouths, bro.
Wild shopping spree, buying tons of super fancy clothes. Sounds fun, but it wasn't.
No shit. It's coming from a man here. Shopping's boring. What you gonna buy? You gonna take it home and you're gonna... That's the great part. It's taking it home. I don't wanna fucking go around stores. It makes my feet hurt. I wanna walk around. I could go walk a lap down the... Two blocks away from here.
Gave it to her. It's so funny because everyone will believe it's a fake one.
In reality, they're just gonna sell it and buy some more crack. Yeah, that's the whole thing. All right, they're gonna buy more alcohol, more crack, because they got something expensive they could just sell out for them to feed more of their addiction.
Even though it's real, I started laughing with them, even though I thought it was absolutely disgusting. I mean, with that money, they could have rented her a home for a month.
Yeah, so they could bring their friends and do more crack in there. Okay. Oh, I apologize. They probably do need a home. But that's... sitting in the empty room is not good for you. It's gonna make you look like you're in a sane asylum.
Or bought her food for weeks. At least they accepted
I
me.
I made a severe, we were sitting down at an expensive restaurant
when one of them spotted a beggar
and
outside.
I don't expect to be forgiven.
He was still in his teens, and I felt so bad. But one of the girls said, why don't we invite him to dine at our table? We order expensive food and wait until he goes to the restroom. That's when we sneak out of the restaurant so that he has to pay the bill. Which, of course, he can't.
Oh, he gonna be washing a lot of dishes. I mean, a lot and a lot of dishes.
They all started laughing again, and one girl went outside to invite the homeless to eat with us. He looked tired, and I asked him to tell us his story, which was heartbreaking. He said his family had thrown him out when he was only 14.
This is not getting me any information. Why should I sympathize with this guy? He probably like fucking vaped in the bathroom, got caught, and he got kicked out because he was smuggling weed in his bag, in his backpack or something. I don't feel bad for the guy.
It's gone. We all stood up and left, but I quickly threw $300 on the table so he wouldn't get in trouble for not being able to pay. Things got even crazier when I was invited to my classmate Sergey's birthday party.
Hold up.
He was only 16, but living in his own New York City penthouse.
No shit, man. I see it up there. I am it.
I did some research and found out that it costs $30,000 a month to rent it.
Oh, so this guy's a fucking fraud. He's a tax evasion kind of dude. Well, you're only paying $30,000 to rent a penthouse, and you haven't even bought the penthouse. That is sad. That is depressing. Even Jeff Bezos could buy that shit. You gotta check this thumbnail out, bro. It's gonna interest you a lot. What the fuck am I looking at? What am I looking at?
Who is this?
Hey, Shorty.
I mean me.
Sweet Jesus, this fucking water park is Compton for children. Did you hear the kid? He said, hey, Shorty. Pulls out with a fucking pumped up shotgun. Oh, my Lord. Hold up now.
Yeah, cool off. And more. Now this is what I call real fun.
Bro, I can't with the narrator. She sounds like Mickey Mouse. No, scratch that. That's Minnie Mouse. Don't just confuse the gender. Oh, here comes the Twitter comments. Here comes the comments. Here comes Twitter. Crying again. So we're gonna have everybody reacting to me. They'll be like, it'll be like fucking Hassan over here. Hassan Pike will be like, oh, I can't believe this guy, bro. He misgendered a cartoon character from a Disney joke. I'm like, it's Mickey. It's a mouse. It's a mouse. It's a mouse. It's a cartoon mouse. Leave me alone.
Cry, baby. Stop. You are a loser.
Guys, we live in a society. That's it. We just live in a society.
Fine. I'll share some ice cream. You get the best. Here. More.
I'm gonna kill some kids today. That was a joke, by the way. I'm not actually gonna do it. You think I'm fucked in the head? Well, you fucked in the head. Think that I was gonna do it.
Aw, drop it! Get back from her!
Yay!
Or you are gonna mess with us! Huh? I have something to top that! Ciao, girls!
Pikachu, I choose you! You guys remember they used to show you tricks and tips? Not anymore. They changed over the years. Cocoa melon. That's what they are. Anyways, I have enough with this cancer. Bro's been cooking in the sun way too long, bro. Get some sunscreen in your face before you even go outside, bro. Come on now, we all know that. Bro, look like a hot Cheeto. I think I'm done here for the day, bro. I think I'm done. I think I'm done with this fucking video. I think we're good. I think we're done. I think I need to just go to therapy. So what you think? You gonna keep doing these videos? Gotta keep the channel alive. Hold on. I'm gonna go back to the street and I'm gonna go beg for money. You stay here and you're going to do all this by yourself, okay? Unless a fucking ghostville from the future comes to me and then tells me my channel's okay, then I'll be good. But right now, I am going to go to the street and beg for some bread and hope for the Queen of France to give me some cake.